Greetings from Olympia. I'm your state senator, Linda Evans Parlette. We are now in the fifth week of the legislative session, and there's some key things that have happened. One, the state operating budget continues to be a major focus. A little bit of background. The legislature must work on two operating budgets. The 2009-11 budget, which ends June 30th, that's this biennium. It is still more than a half a billion dollars in the red. Well, by law, it must be in balance by June 30th. After that, number two, we will need to write the 2011-13 budget. That budget already has a deficit of approximately $4.6 billion. In late January, the House voted on a bill to begin addressing this current budget that has to balance in June. On Friday of last week, the Senate passed the bill, but made some key changes to what the House had given us. The Senate version makes smaller cuts to K-12 education. It also achieves a higher level of savings than the House or the governor's proposal did. It also begins making major reforms to some of our major programs, for example, the basic health plan. Another key difference, the Senate bill was crafted in a bipartisan style, with input from both sides of the aisle. That's absolutely refreshing. So the next step is for the House and the Senate to negotiate a final budget. It has to pass out of the House, come back to the Senate, and then on to the governor's office. No matter what it looks like, this budget and the next one all involve very difficult choices. I'm very mindful that these cuts will have great impacts on the people in North Central Washington and all across the state. It's going to be a painful session. Another issue, unemployment insurance, a real major topic this week as it was last week. Last Friday, the Senate passed Senate Bill 5135. This bill would do two things. It would protect employers from the $300 million in unemployment insurance tax increases this year. It also would extend federally funded benefits for approximately 70,000 Washington families. Unemployment taxes rose by $364 million last year. They're also projected to increase an average of 36% more this year. So this Senate bill would smooth out the 2011 tax increase to give our employers time to get back on their feet. The House passed their version of the bill this morning, House Bill 1091. This contains all of the Senate provisions, but it also makes the tax changes permanent. It also provides an expansion of training benefits available to unemployed workers. This change would leverage $98 million in additional federal funds. This money will be partially used to fund a temporary benefit increase of $25 per week for unemployed workers with claims between March and November. The House approved their bill earlier today, and now the Senate hopefully will consider the House bill on Friday. The House version is expected to move forward, and then after the Senate votes on it, we will head that to the governor's office. Time is of the essence. A single version has to be agreed upon this week because the state has to recalculate their tax rates and get the notices out to employers. So that bill is time sensitive. Let me talk a little bit about the committees that I sit on as to what's going on this week. To begin with, Ways and Means. On Wednesday, we are discussing state pension and compensation issues. Also on the same day, in the Senate Environment, Water, and Energy Committee, there is a hearing on a bill that I introduced, Senate Bill 555. I call this the Water South Bill, and what it requires is that the Department of Ecology has to notify the county commissioners where water rights are taken either interbasin, somewhere else in the county, or outside of the county. I call this the Sunshine Bill. The purpose of that is to notify the county commissioners because they are concerned that if water goes out of their county, then that would affect the economic conditions of the county in the future. Finally, we are approaching some important deadlines. February 21st, it's the last day for House and Senate bill committees to act on their own bills. February 25th, that is the last day for House and Senate fiscal committees to act on their own bills. And finally, March 7th, that's a Monday, That's the last day for the House and the Senate to vote on their own bills. That's called the House of Origin bills. Those deadlines don't apply to any bills that are considered necessary to implement the budget. Thanks again for the opportunity to represent you in the Washington State Senate. And if you're in Olympia, please let me know. I welcome your visit. Until next week, thank you for the honor of representing you.